This is Anurag Singh. So he's from CMI. So he's a postdoc in CMI. And he'll be speaking on bounded degree complexes of forms. Yeah, Anurag, you can start.
Yeah, thank you, sir. Thank you for the introduction. I would also like to thank all the organizers for giving this opportunity to talk over here. So the aim of this talk is to just give a brief survey about these particular bounded degree complexes associated with graphs. So let me first start with a very classical notion from graph theory, which is a matching. Matching is nothing but a collection of edges from the graph with the property that any two edges do not intersect, or maybe they don't have a common vertex. For example, if you take a complete graph, the edge 1, 3 and 2, 4 form a matching. Similarly, edge 1, 4 and 2, 3 form a matching. So given a graph, you can have many matchings. And this has a very beautiful property that if you have a matching and you take any sub-collection of that matching, that is again a matching. So any sub-collection of a matching is again a matching. Now with this property in our hand, we can define a simplicial complex associated with this. Given any graph, we can define a simplicial complex. And the simplices of the simplicial complex are nothing but all the matchings of the graph. For example, you take this graph in the left hand side and you realize that what edges B and C do have a common vertex, say, so they will not form a simplex in the matching complex. Similarly, the edges B and A have a common vertex. On the other hand, B and D do not have a common vertex, so there is a edge between B and D in the matching complex. Yeah, so a little bit of history about these complexes, why these complexes are famous and why these and how they started. So it was in 1979 when Gauss was working on the Titz-Kossuth complexes. So a particular example of Titz-Kossuth complex is Kossuth complex. So they are related with some group and given a list of subgroups of this complex. So he realized that when you take the symmetric group and the subgroups are all those elements which fixes the value I, then you actually recover a complex associated with this particular graph. And he called this complex chessboard complex. Till 1992, there was no further progress on these complexes, though they appeared in many different places. Like in the work of Jivalevic and Resica in 1992 itself, they were dealing with the Perberg type problems. In the same year, Bauk was also working on the Brown's complexes, and they are the complexes obtained from posets of P subgroups of a given group G. So he realized to understand this complex, even for the value P equal to 2, it is important to understand the topology of this particular complex, which is coming from a graph. Then he started the study of these complexes and computed the commutative formula for the Betti number of these matching complexes. So this represents the Betti number. And I must mention here that he just not gave the commutative formula for the Betti number. He also gave a representation of the symmetric group on the homology of this complex. So the representation, there's a natural action of the symmetric group on this complete graph by permuting the vertices of the graph that gives back action on this matching complex. And he realized that determining the topology or the homotopy type of these complexes are not very easy because there is a torsion available in the homology groups. And in fact, this is the smallest non-trivial place where the homology survives, and we have a torsion which is G3 available over there. After his work, there were many other results which came regarding the connectivity of these complexes and the integral homology and so on. And similar results were obtained for the matching complexes of complete bipartite graph as well. Now this motivated Reiner and Roberts to generalize the notion of the matching complexes, now so-called bounded degree complexes. What is that? In a matching, what do you have? You have the property that matching is a subgraph in which the degree of any vertex is at most 1. So what if you relax this condition 1 and say you assign this value lambda to the vertices of the graph and you collect all the subgraphs satisfying the property that the degree of the vertex in this graph is less than equal to the assigned value, then this also satisfies the hereditary property and you get a simplicial complex. For example, when you have this graph in the left, you get this particular simplicial complex. Here the main point is when you take lambda is equal to 2, 2, 2 and 2, even E2, E3 is not a subset of any simplex over here because they have a vertex of degree 3. So maximum simplices of this complex are just these three maximum simplices. Yeah, so when you have the image is equal to 1, you recover your matching complex. And this is why when image is equal to R, people call it R matching complexes, which is denoted by BD R of G. Yeah, so using the same funda that Bauk used in his result, he computed the rational homology of these complexes when the graph G was complete graph or complete partite graph. So this left the following two questions unanswered. The first one was, we cannot compute the homotopy type of matching complex of KN exactly in all the cases, but what if we don't take lambda is equal to 1? What if we take lambda bigger? Can we compute the homotopy type? If we cannot compute the homotopy type, at least can we say about the connectivity degree of these complexes? But the connectivity degree is nothing but the smallest place where the higher homotopy group is non-trivial. I'm assuming that pi zero represents the connectivity of this complex. So that's what it is here. And having these questions in mind, Johnson in 2008 in his PhD started studying the homotopy type of BD R of KN. And when he realized that when you fix N and vary R, you get the following filtration. His main idea was that on the top you have the simplex of this dimension, and on the bottom you have the empty set. In between, what are the complexes are coming? Can you actually say what the homotopy type is or the connectivity? But he soon realized that it is not actually easy to compute the homotopy type because of the availability of the torsion in the homology, even in the case when lambda is not equal to 1. So he shifted his attention from computing the homotopy type to compute the connectivity degree of these complexes. He proved that the connectivity degree of two matching complexes of KN is bounded below by this, and three matching complexes is bounded below by this. For bigger R, he also computed the Euler characteristic of the Alexander dual of BD R of KN. Now, having the Euler characteristic of Alexander dual, it is easy to compute the Euler characteristic of the given complex. So he actually computed the Euler characteristic of R matching complex of KN when R belongs to N minus 3 and N minus 2. He also gave a general lower bound for the connectivity of these bounded degree complex of complete curve. But he also said that this bound is general because they are far from being tight. Even for lambda is equal to 2, he realized that these bounds are pretty far from each other. So he posed a problem in his thesis that what can we say about the connectivity of R matching complex of complete graphs? Now recently I have been able to show that the connectivity degree of N minus 2 matching complex of complete graph is exactly like this. And not only that, I was able to compute the exact homotopy type of these complexes, which was the first time we have complete class of homotopy type known for anything. And using the same methods that I did here, I was able to compute the R matching complexes of complete bipartite graph, and similarly the N minus 1 matching complex of KNN. Now, so far I have spoken about complete graph and complete bipartite graph, but there's also a theory when the graphs are not complete, when the graphs are not complete in the sense for the general graphs. So the first major result in this direction came in 2008 when Mariotti and Testa was able to prove that the matching complexes of trees is always homotopy equivalent to Wedge spheres. So this posed the following problem. What happens when you take lambda other than 1? What happens with the homotopy type of bounded degree complexes of trees? Now this question was, last year Vera was trying to answer this question, but she restricted herself with a particular class of trees called caterpillar graph, and these graphs are nothing but a tree with a central path, and on each vertex on the central path you have mi leaves. For example, G243 is nothing but a central path with two vertices, and on the first vertex you have 4 leaves, on the second vertex you have 3 leaves. When the number of leaves on each vertex is equal, you call it perfect caterpillar graph, and you denote by GNM. So she was able to prove that the two matching complex of perfect caterpillar graph is homotopy equivalent to wedge of sphere. And she had an intuition that this is actually true for any caterpillar graph. The bounded degree complex of any caterpillar graph are homotopy equivalent to wedge of spheres. And recently I was able to show that her conjecture is true. And this is in fact the case, that bounded degree complex of any caterpillar graph is homotopy equivalent to wedge of spheres. So these are some technicalities I'm not getting into, but I was also able to generalize this result for any tree. That you take a tree, the bounded degree complexes of trees are always homotopy equivalent to spheres, which implies a very simple result for the cycle graph, that bounded degree complex of cycle graph is always homotopy equivalent to wedge of spheres. Yeah, so now in this direction there are many questions that have opened, but I would like to pose some which are available in the literature. The first question is the conjecture of Johnson, which he gave in his thesis. The first, like he said, that the connectivity that he found is tight for the two matching complex of complete graphs. The second thing to ask is, what happens when you take the k matching complex of complete graph? What is the smallest k? For example, that we have recently shown that this is always Bezier of spheres, but in the matching complex we know there is a torsion. So we can ask, what is the smallest value k where there is no torsion in all the homology group of the BDK of Kn? The next question, the similar question can be asked for the complete apartheid graph. For the matching complex of complete graph, we know there is torsion, but for the top subcomplex in the filtration, we know there is no torsion, they are homotopy equivalent to Bezier spheres. So can we compute the smallest k for which they don't have torsion and everything is homotopy equivalent to Bezier spheres? And yeah, so these three questions are available. And other than that, there are other families of graphs which have also been studied very well. One of them is grid graph. And in 2018, Matsushita was able to show that the matching complex of the grid graph is homotopy equivalent to Bezier spheres. And computation of the bounded degree complex of grid graph is still open. So it would be interesting to see if the bounded degree complex of grid graphs are also homotopy equivalent to Bezier spheres. Yeah. And that's it. That was it. Thank you. So.
Okay, so thank you, Anurag, for the nice talk. Thank you.